Since NASA's Artemis 1 mission's Orion splashdown last month, many parts of the rocket and mission data are being closely evaluated by NASA engineers.
And as our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler explains, two experiments now back at the Cape are all about astronaut radiation exposure.
There are many astronaut dangers when it comes to spaceflight, especially with a new rocket like NASA's SLS that was used on the test mission for the Artemis program.
And liftoff of Artemis 1.
It and the Orion spacecraft are NASA's way to get humans back on the moon and pave the way for travel to Mars. So data and tests, the top priority.
We haven't had astronauts in deep space for the time periods previously that we're expecting to see in the Artemis program.
Meet Zohar and Helga, two female mannequins that traveled inside the Orion craft on the 25-day mission, now back at the Kennedy Space Center. Their job, test the radiation levels in the capsule. Zohar was wearing a radiation protective vest. They both had radiation detectors. Upcoming Artemis missions will have women crew members, as this is the first time female astronauts will go into deep space and for extended periods of time. The testing had to reflect that.
These mannequins have some female characteristics, and so this will help us understand how the female body reacts to exposure to radiation in space as well.
Orion traveled farther into deep space than any other spacecraft for humans. New territory for radiation exposure. So the data, critical for astronaut safety.
Basically, the sensors are radiation sensors. So they'll measure the level of critical radiation that can actually do damage to the human body. And so they'll look at different layers. What is the radiation level at the layer of the skin? How much radiation is internal?
Engineers will then compare the readings between the two mannequins to see the radiation exposure difference and to what degree of protection the vest provided. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.